get those lights on. We need another power core.
Timing. Hartman just came through here. God, he was hideous. He tore the security door into the Break Falls AWE site wide open. He was so ugly. Like, wow, I got a good look at him, and Christ, he does not look like he used to. The hiss must have messed him up or something. He looks like a bar rag that's been twisted by the world's strongest men. Or a monster from some 80s horror movie. You know, back when it was all practical effects? Ugh, nasty.
Real Did professional. You say
something? Remember, I can't hear you. Never mind, just go after Hartman. Oh,
so disgusting.
I've written, rewritten. The darkness wants to hide the past and make me lose my way. I trust what I read on these pages. I wrote them for a reason. Cut through the reality, tear it apart, and rewrite it. They are drawn to the mystery.
Stuck. Let's thank you for meeting with us again, Dr. Harmon.
It's my pleasure, gentlemen. I hope the information I've provided thus far has been of some small use.
It's been invaluable, Doctor. We have a much clearer picture of this event, thanks to your accounts.
Well, I do consider myself a keen observer.
We did have one question, though. You mentioned in an earlier conversation that your patients displayed, and I'm paraphrasing here, unnatural abilities that you in fact encouraged during their time in your lodge. It'd be very helpful if you could fill us in on the details there.
Of course. Like yourselves, I work to understand and even bend the rules of our earthly paradigm. My patients' well-being was paramount, of course, but I would hardly be a man of science if I did not reach out at the underlying truth. As I stated in my written proposal, I believe working alongside your organization could be greatly beneficial to both parties. Sharing notes, as they say.
Thank you, Doctor. That's all we need to hear. Remy?
Dr. Emil Hartman, you have been found in breach of codes 4, 8, and 74 of the Federal Bureau of Control Criminal Offenses.
What? You can't do this? I am a well-connected man. You're making a dire mistake, my friend.
You will be detained until further notice and all personal property will be confiscated, including the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
That's preposterous. You can't just seize my property. I'm a United States citizen. I have rights. That lodge is my life's work. I'm offering you years of research.
Get him out of here.
You're making a mistake. You have to listen to me. You have to listen.
Again, I had a plan. I know it. I forgot.
Whatever is going on with Wake, he clearly needs some help.
Escape, right? His escape.
Wake needed a hero. A hero needed a crisis. For the part in the story about the government agency, Wake needed something special, something to convey an alien force mimicking human intelligence.
Another replica, like the one they made for Ordinary. I wonder what happened here.
Notes of Dr. Emil Hartman. I am continuing my work alone again since certain parties were denied to recognize a golden opportunity. Like my generous offer, the conversations came to naught. Some people simply do not value collaboration as I do. Though I believe now that it was for the best. The sort of old pioneering work that I am undertaking cannot survive under the shackles of bureaucracy and regulation. I have a history of seeking such partnerships. There was a time when I hoped Alan Wake and I could collaborate. Together we could have produced art such that the world has never seen it. It was stubborn and artistic. Writers usually are. Disappointing nonetheless. Now, like Tom before him, Wake has disappeared into Cauldron Lake. And this is where my work turns. I can think. Since he was lost into the lake, Thomas Zane was being served by various townspeople. This indicates to me that the individuals within the lake are not entirely gone. I anticipate that a similar return. Harbor some resentment.
Dr.
Determination, undeniable. From this, I have concluded that the lake and the dark place within it are not as removed from this world as I previously thought. Given my acute awareness of what awaits within, my meticulous preparations, and my considerable education, I believe myself much more prepared than either Tom or Wake. I should be able to cross into that dark realm with a chance to return as they are. All that remains is the dive itself. It frightens me, I admit, but such is the burden of the truth. Take my plunge into the dark tomorrow with only the light of knowledge to guide me. It's time for a break. Until I return.
Darkness in the driver's seat!
Thank you.
Hartman won't be a problem anymore, Langston. But Investigations needs someone to run it. Interested?
I've seen what happens to sector heads, ma'am. No, thank you. Ma'am, I'm getting something on my terminal here, an AWE alert from Bright Falls, Washington. But it might be a glitch. The date's all wrong, a couple of years in the future. And we're in lockdown, there shouldn't be any incoming signals.
Maybe it was active before we went into lockdown? Are there agents on site?
Let me check. Agent Estevez is the field agent in charge of monitoring the site, so she should be there to let us know if the situation has been through any major changes recently.
Set in motion. If the alarm's true, then so is the reason for the alarm. The effect must follow the cause. It's happening again. A return. You have been warned.
This must be where they studied Hartman. Kinda looks like Dylan's cell. I wonder if they treated him as badly.
Ranger sent to this location, stat.
It's an honor, Director.